हाय फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। हाय, आई एम प्रभाकर, एप्टीट्यूड ट्रेनर, डीबीएस इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज कावल। फ्रेंड्स, इन द वेक ऑफ कोरोना most of the students cannot afford or cannot venture to go for coaching for MCET to other places. Keeping this point in view, our management, our college management has taken a decision or has initiated MCET online coaching classes for the benefit of the students who are aspiring for MCET and other sets. So, in this short time, we may not complete the entire syllabus, but to the maximum possible, we try to cover all the important problems in all chapters. Just like what are the questions asked in the previous MCETs and what are the various other important problems. So in every chapter, we take those problems, we select some problems, and those problems will be explained to you in detail. And we request you to make the best use of these videos. And we also request you to share this video if you like and subscribe DBS Talks YouTube channel to get notifications. As and when we release videos, you get notifications so that you can make the best use of these videos. You don't miss any video. Hope we are taking all care to give you the maximum benefit. So students, please make the best use of these videos. Right friends? So today I am taking some selected problems in the chapter probability. So some selected problems in probability. So first problem I take, this is some selected problems. See, A speaks truth in 80% of the cases. A speaks truth in 80% of the cases, while B speaks 90% of the cases. B speaks truth in 90% of the cases. In narrating same thing, what is the probability they contradict each other? What is the probability they contradict each other? Contradicting each other means if A says truth, B must tell lie, and if B says truth and A must tell lie. So what is the probability that A tells truth is 80%, that is equal to PA is equal to 80 by 100, 24s, 25s. So A tells the truth is 4 by 5. Whereas B tells the truth is 90 by 100, that is equal to 9 by 10. So A tells truth 4 by 5. So A tells false or A lies is 1 minus 4 by 5, that is equal to 1 by 5. This is about A. In case of B, the probability of B telling the truth is 9 by 10. So 1 minus 9 by 10, 1 by 10 is the probability that B tells false. So now we want the probability they contradict each other. That is, if A tells the truth, B must tell false or lie. If B tells the truth, A must tell lie. So this into this plus this into this gives us the required probability. Look at friends, 4 by 5 into 1 by 10 plus 1 by 5 or 9 by 10 into 1 by 5. So this comes to 4 by 50 plus 9 by 50, 13 by 50, 13 by 50. If you want to convert into percentage, let us do into 100, 50 twos, 13 twos, 26%. So this is the probability that they contradict each other, friends. Okay, friends, very important problem. Let us take another problem. See, friends, I have selected some problems which are likely to be asked in your MCET. See, same type of problem, just slightly differs. A tells the truth in 80% of the cases. A tells the truth in 80% of the cases, whereas B tells the truth in 90% of the cases. A tells the truth 80%, B tells the truth 90%. In narrating the same thing, in what is the probability they agree with each other? They agree with each other. Agree with each other means if A tells the truth, B also must tell the truth. If A tells lie, B must also tell lie. So let us see, the probability A tells the truth is equal to 80 by 100, that is equal to 4 by 5. This is for telling the truth. 1 minus 4 by 5 gives 1 by 5. This is the probability that A tells false. Coming to B, the probability of B telling the truth is 90%. 90%, that is equal to 9 by 10. So 1 minus 9 by 10, 1 by 10. So these are the probabilities. Now we want the probability that they both agree with each other. So if A tells the truth, B must also tell the truth. So 4 by 5 into 9 by 10 plus 1 by 5 into 1 by 10. So that comes to 36 by 50 plus 1 by 50, that is equal to 37 by 50 into 100. If we do into 100, we get the percentage. So 37 2s, 74%. So in 74% of the cases, they agree with each other. This is the probability that they should agree with each other. Okay, friends, this is another important problem. Contradicting each other means cross multiplication. And telling the, they agree with each other, same thing. Truth into truth plus false into false. Adding those two things, we get the required properties. Okay, friends. Let us see some other problems which I have considered to be important for your MCET or for any other sets. Here one more problem is, friends, which I have selected. There are 3 red socks, 4 green socks and 3 blue socks. 3 red socks and 4 green socks and three blue socks. Three blue socks. From these, now we have 10 socks. 10 socks are there. We have chosen two socks. What is the probability that the selected two socks are of the same color? So we want the same color. See, probability of an event is favorable cases by total number of cases or sample space. Probability of this event, of course, probability of any event goes like this. Favorable cases by total number of cases. Total number of cases, first let us count. Total number of cases means there are 10 socks are there. From 10 socks, in how many ways we select 2 socks, that is 10C2. Now we want our favor. What favor we want? The socks must be of the same color. Either the two socks may be red or green or blue. So favorable cases is it can be either two red socks from three red socks, or it can be two green socks, or it can be either two blue socks. So 3C2 means 3C1, that is 3, 4C2 value 6 friends, 3C1 means 3, by 10C2, 10C2 is 10 into 9 by 2, 90 by 2, 45. So, total 12 by 45, 4 by 15, this is the required probability, Okay, this is another important problem, friends. Friends, one more question can be asked on this data. In this question, what is the problem? Both the socks are of the same color. If the question is, if both the socks are different in colors, so then we have to consider three cases. One red and one green, that is 3C1 into 4C1, it can be one red and one green, or it can be one green and one blue, 4C1 into 3C1, plus it can be one blue and one red, 3C1 into 3C1. See, 3C1 3 4C1 4 3 into 4 12, plus 4 into 3, 12, plus 3 into 3, 9, by 10C2, 45 you have seen. So, 24 plus 9, 33 by 45, friends, 3 11s, 3 15s. So, 11 by 15 is the required probability. So, this is one more important problem, friends. If we want different, both the socks are different in color, it can be either one red, one green, or one green, one blue, or one blue, one red. So, like this, we can solve this problem, friends. So, this is one more problem. And the next problem I have selected for you, friends, is see, A jar contains 5 red balls and 5 black balls. 5 red balls and 5 black balls. The jar contains 5 red and 5 black balls. What happened? One ball is picked at random and discarded without noticing the color. One ball is picked at random and it is discarded without noticing the color of the ball. Now we want the probability to get a red ball in the second draw. In the first draw, one ball is drawn and without noticing the color of the ball, it was discarded. Now, what is the probability to get a ball in the second draw? If you go for second draw, what is the probability that the ball is red in color? See, in the first draw,
the first draw, the ball may be either red or black. Let us assume the ball is red. So what is the probability of drawing red ball? 5/10. The probability of drawing a red ball is 5/10. And the second ball must also be red. The second ball, second draw, we have to get a red ball. Now how many red balls are remaining? 4 red balls are remaining. And total balls are 9 because we have discarded that ball. This is case 1. Plus, let us assume that the first ball is black. What is the probability of drawing the black ball? That is also 5/10. 5/10 into the second ball should be red. In the second draw, the ball should be red. So the red balls are same because we have drawn black ball in the first draw. So the second ball, red balls are the same, but the total number of balls are 9. So adding these two probabilities, we get the final probability 20/90 plus 25/90. Total comes to 45/90. That comes to 1/2. So this is the required probability, friends. Let us see one more problem, friends. See, the next problem I have selected, friends, is this. Each of the two boxes A and B contain 10 chips numbered from 1 to 10. There are two boxes A and B. These two boxes contain chips numbered from 1 to 10. What happened? If one chit is drawn at random from each of A and B, one chit is drawn from box A and also from box B, then the probability that the number on the chit drawn from A is less than the number drawn on the chit drawn from B. So this number, the number which we draw from box A must be less than from box B. Okay, friends. So we know probability of any event is favorable cases by total number of cases. Here there are 10 chips. In how many ways? We can draw 2 chips. 10 into 10. There will be 100 elements in the sample space. Again, starting with the 2. Again, we have 10. 10 into 10. 100 elements are there, will be in the sample space. Out of these 100 elements, how many cases are favorable to us? What favor we want? This number must be less than this number. If we draw 10 from the box B, then there will be 9 cases. Because if we draw 10 from the box B, then we have to draw only from 1 to 9. Because this must be less than box B. If we draw 9 from the second box, we have only 8 cases. So we have to draw only from 1 to 8. Like this, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. On adding the 1 to 9, the total is 45. So, the favorable cases are 45, total number of cases 100, 5 9s, 5 20s. 9/20 is the required probability, friends. 9/20 is the required probability. Okay, friends, this is one more important problem. I would like to consider two problems on Bayes' theorem. Bayes' theorem is a very, very important concept, friends. As you know, Bayes' theorem problems based on Bayes' theorem is very, very important problem, friends. We do in a simple manner, in a smart way, we can solve this. We can get the probability based on
Bayes theorem problems. See, this problem is there in Bayes theorem. See, bag 1 contains 4 white and 6 black balls. Bag 1 contains 4 white and 6 black balls. And bag 2 contains 4 white and 3 black balls. 4, 6 and 4, 3. What happened? One ball is drawn at random from one of the bags. One ball is drawn at random from one of the boxes. And it is found to be black. What is the question here? The probability that it was drawn from bag 1. This is a very simple question, friends. See, here there are two bags. So, probability of drawing the bags
is 1 by 2. This is the probabilities of bags. Probability of drawing from first bag 1 by 2. Probability of drawing from second bag is 1 by 2. This is bag's probability. And the drawn ball is found to be black. So what is the probability of drawing black ball from the first thing? From the first bag 1. 6 by 4 plus 6 10. 6 by 10. That is equal to 2 3 is 2 5. 2 by 3 by 5. What is the probability of drawing black ball from the second one? That is 3 by 7. This is, friends, these four things are enough. This is very clear. 1 by 2. And drawing black ball from the first bag is 3 by 5. Drawing black ball from the second bag is 3 by 7. Now we want that the ball drawn must be from the first bag. See, ball drawn from the first bag. This is the information related to first bag. This is Bayes theorem only, friends. Because we are going for multiple choice questions. I am not giving all the formulas. This is simple thing. The ball must be drawn from the first bag. This into this. 1 by 2 into 3 by 5. This is what you do in Bayes theorem. 1 by 2 into 3 by 5 by 1 by 2 into 3 by 5 plus 1 by 2 into 3 by 7. That's all, friends. 1 by 2 into 3 by 5 plus 1 by 2 into 3 by 7. See, 3 by 10. Numerator 3 by 10. Denominator 3 by 10 plus 3 by 14. This is equal to 3 by 10 whole by 14. 3s are 42 plus 10 is 30. 72 by 140. This is equal to 3 by 10 into 140 by 72. 0, 0 cancel and 3 ones. 324s, 212s, 27s, 7 by 12. 7 by 12 is the required probability for this problem. So, very simple thing. You can easily solve the problems when given on based on a Bayes theorem. Okay, friends. One more important problem which is frequently asked in this thing is,
a letter is known to have received from, a letter is known to have come from either London or Clifton. A letter is known to have come from either London or Clifton. On the postmark, only the two consecutive letters are visible. two consecutive letters on, O-N, O-N, are visible. So what is the probability that it came from London? That it came from London. Same thing friends. Very simple thing. Here there are only two places. The letter must come from either London or Clifton. So probability of coming from London is 1 by 2. Probability of coming from London is London probability. And Clifton is again 1 by 2. And the second thing, two letters on the postmark are visible. What are those two postmarks? O-N. So how many consecutive pairs are there in London? How many consecutive pairs are there in London? So, LO one pair, ON one pair, ND one pair, DO one pair, ON one pair. See, those two letters visible on the postmark is ON. So, those two letters, the probability that the two letters belong to the letter came from London is two favorable cases by total number of pairs are how many? 5. 2 by 5. This is regarding London case. If we take Clifton, how many consecutive letters are there? C consecutive pairs CL, LI, IF, FT, TO, ON. So how many pairs are there? There are 6 consecutive pairs are there, friends. In 6 consecutive friends, our pair ON is only 1 ON is there. So if the letter is to come from Clifton, that is 1 by 6. Oh friends, our task is over. Two letters ON are visible. In how many ways, what is the probability that the two visible letters pertains to London? That is 2 by 5. Because in London, we have 6 consecutive pairs. Out of these 6 consecutive pairs, we have 2 ONs are there. So, favorable cases 2, total number of pairs 5, 2 by 5. But whereas in Clifton, there is only one such pair is there, that is ON, remaining are different pairs. So, ON 1 by 6. The same thing, friends. Bayes' theorem. This is London, this is Clifton. We want the probability that the letter should receive from London. So, 1 by 2 into 2 by 5 is the numerator. 1 by 2 into 2 by 5 is the numerator. By what is the denominator, friends? This into this plus this into this. As I discussed in the previous problem, 1 by 2 into 2 by 5 plus 1 by 12 into 1 by 6. 1 by 12 into 1 by, sorry, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 6. So, here 1 by 2, here is 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, all 1 by 2's are cancelled. And the remaining expression is 2 by 5 by 2 by 5 plus 1 by 6. 2 by 5 plus 1 by 6. That is equal to 2 by 5 by 6 2's are 12 plus 5 1's are 5. 12 plus 5 17. 17 by 5 6's are 30. That is equal to 2 by 5 into 30 by 17, 5 6s, 6 2s are 12, 12 by 17. So, 12 by 17 is the required probability, friends. So, if problems based on Bayes' theorem, you can do like this simple, friends. If you follow this logic, the problem can be solved in very simple way. So, let us see some more critical problems, some more problems which are asked in previous MCET exams. We shall discuss those problems, friends. Have a nice day.